The State of the Union is strong. Running participation continues to grow in both the U.S. and in Maine. We're really in the midst of the second running boom, which many experts believe started in the early 90s when the baby boomers kind of returned to the sport. That first boom generation kind of started returning to the sport after they had kids, got settled down. And then their kids started to run. And right now, Generation Y, the millennials, the demographics are there, and those people are really enjoying running. By any measure, there's almost 50 million people who run at least once per year. 27.7 million run at least 50 days. And not to brag, but I just finished like 83 days in a row. Of 18.3 million frequent runners, people that run 100 days a year. And all these categories, any measure of it you look at, it's like it's up 8%, 12%, 11%, and it's been like this for several years in a row, really since the early 90s, but in particularly since 2000. And with that, running opportunities are growing, so you've got just a ton more races up. The 5K is the most popular distance by far. There's something like, there's just tens of thousands of 5Ks out there. And then it's, 11,000 5Ks, 2,500 10Ks, 1,200 half marathons, 625 marathons that you can choose from to run. It's terrific. The trend, runners are going long. Obviously the 5K is popular, but really the fastest growth that we're seeing nationwide is in the half marathon distance. 1.4 million finishers last year, which is a record number. It's growing at a 24% annual clip. Three times as many runners in 2000, and well over half of those participants are female.
Yay.
Very cool. Marathon as well, going very fast. And we've got great opportunities at both those distances, right here in Maine. So what is going on in Maine? Maine Track Club is clearly reflects the trend nationwide. So our membership is up, race participation is up. The club is offering more group runs. There's a lot of other group runs that are popping up around town and throughout the state. The club as a whole, it's growing. It's enjoying the benefits of more people running. So the bottom line, we've got a little bit more money in the bank, and we're able to give away a lot more. So MTC membership, very strong. The last board meeting in December, we topped 500 household memberships, and I think that might be the first time we've done that. No, I'm sorry, with the 300 renewals, it's the first time we've topped 800. If you figure those renewals will start coming in here pretty soon in January, which is usually the case. And that reflects the chunder, it looks like you've got a download. That reflects that whopping 864 likes that we have on Facebook. A very robust, growing, active membership. Our races are growing too. Here are the six events that the Maine Track Club owns. Not a lot of people, even members, really realize which events that the Track Club owns. We insure six properties, and we're responsible for six events. Starting with the Midwinter Classic, which is coming up. Hopefully everybody here in this room got their bib. It's not going to snow this year, we've decided. The new race, the Runways Half Marathon in April. It's Iowa 5-mile road race, main marathon events. The Farm to Farm Ultra Run, which replaced the old Pentaville 50, formerly the MTC 50. The growing Turkey Trot. So those are the six races that we have. And then roughly about a dozen, 15 races that the club historically supports. And by support, it's a lot of it's Bob and Charlie out there with the timing equipment, and then the handfuls of volunteers that we send to the to work the finish lines for those events as well. Just kind of rip through kind of the status of each race last year. So Midwinter Classic was kind of a bust last year, although it did sell out. We had two postponements and the ultimate cancellation of the event due to weather and snow does happen. 2011 race, the Runways, half marathon, 5K, 1 mile race, just a wild success. 800 total runners. That snow happens, but fortunately the night before the race, and just very successful, great event. I'm still hearing people that are just raving about it and are psyched for it this year. Pete's Island Road Race, another very popular race. You can see I've kind of charted out kind of how many finishers we've had over the last several years. You see pretty consistent growth. We lost a few runners this year, but it's certainly not anything to really, I don't think I raised my eyebrows quite yet. We're still way higher than we were in 07 on that race. And really hardly any marketing for that event. Main Marathon, awesome. Sold out again. A little bit earlier this year than last year, and that's a that's a trend nationwide with all the large races. They're selling out earlier and earlier. Clearly, Main Marathon is doing the same thing. Not that much difference on finishers as you would have thought this year would be unusually soggy race day conditions. Good showing. A lot of people showed up. Grant saw too. A race I'm particularly proud of. It's almost a new event, really, although the club has done an ultra marathon for literally decades. Turkey Trot. Awesome job by Michelle and Chris to really grow this race, help grow this race over the last couple years. If you haven't heard yet, they're stepping down as race directors. They will be sorely missed. And I'm missing the turkey soup. I've got a gingerbread man and a snowman. The turkey is kind of my A, so if any of you have that, let me know. Drop it off the dry cleaners first. I'll reimburse you. Big deal around here. So membership is growing, races are growing, our financials, we're club's in good shape right now. We filed our IRS 990 form, just kind of compare and contrast to last year. Grants, it's basically sponsorship, is my understanding of that number. Some membership mixed in there probably. And then services, the bulk of our revenue and income as a club comes from race revenue. This year, or last 2010, we topped $306,000 for the year. We're on track for that for 2011. I have to look at the final spreadsheets, but we're gonna be right up there for 2011 when we file this year. So it really boils down to after you take out all expenses, and expenses here include charitable contributions. Each race gives most of its revenue away to local charities, above and beyond what it costs to run a race. The way the club operates, so if you take the roughly $300,000 of revenue, two-thirds of that revenue is represented by Main Marathon. And the remaining $100,000 boils down to the other five events, and then Usually between $10,000 and $15,000 for membership fees. More interestingly, you know, where does it go? Like I mentioned, each race is kind of in charge of figuring out which charities it wants to work with, and most of those races give directly. But then the MTC board, for the last several years, manages about a $30,000 annual budget. And really that budget goes for things like what we're doing here this evening, the event, food, banquet, possible awards, all the race equipment, starting line stuff, cones, storage, clothing, advertising, meetings, food, picnics, beer picnic this year. Wasn't a huge expenditure. Our big spend this year as a board was for new storage facilities. Super excited about that. We've got two lockers out in Westbrook at Uncle Bob's Storage. So we've got two big 15 foot wide by, I want to say, 25 or 30 feet deep units. Half of that is main marathon equipment, and the rest is for all the other races. It's very convenient. It's two, maybe three times the size of the single unit we used to have. And we've also got a place to park the trailer nearby. It's, you know, several hundred dollars a month to pay for all this, to just to store it, but we have that much equipment we do to run all these races. And I just want to give a thanks to Charlie for helping inventory and organize that. Kevin stepped down from the equipment manager position this year. He did a great job. The storage units just look great. So we're good on the tax forms, and then I just took a look at our last cash statements. Here's the accounts. We're up. We've got, if you take each race, usually it keeps a little in the kitty to continue the next year and kind of start up seed money that remains in most accounts throughout the year. Everything kind of clears through the main master account. But we've got a total cash account right now of a little over $44,000, which is $11,000 more than last year at this time. Anybody get that? So in sum, 2011 is a fantastic year. Participation's up, membership's up, tax forms are in, cash flow positive. We're sitting pretty. But what do we do? You know, what do we do from here? Historically, the club has just kind of managed its budget on kind of an ad hoc basis. We just kind of, the way we operate is, which event is next? What's the next? What's the next banquet? What's the next picnic? What are we doing? I think we get a little focused on the short term, but I think the club right now is in a position to maybe look a little bit beyond that. What other new programs can we do? Can we be doing? What other types of group runs? Can we do more track workouts? Can we do a thing like Bob Reiter's group? Can we do that down here in Portland? The Scarborough, all these things. How can we work more with John Rogers? I'm hearing a lot of yeses and amen over here. So, let's take a little time to think about that, which is what a portion of our membership and volunteers have been doing throughout the year, particularly Jim Haddow, who's been spearheading the strategic planning committee this year, and I'm going to have him talk a little bit more about that. Thank you.